The Manungal jar is a unique Neolithic secondary burial jar with an incised running scroll and impressed decorations. It is painted with hematite. On top of the cover is a boat with two human figures that represent souls on a journey to the afterlife. The human figure in the rear is holding a steering paddle with both hands, the blade of the paddle is missing. The heads of the human figures appear to be wearing a band tied over the crown and under the jaw. The forelimbs of the front figure are folded across the chest, a widespread practice in the Philippines when arranging the corpse. At the front of the boat is the image of the head with eyes, nose and mouth. It is the only burial jar of its kind in the Philippines. The jar was recovered in Chamber A in Manungal Cave Lipu on Point, Palawan during the archaeological exploration undertaken by Dr. Fox in the 1960s. Considered the most significant object in the National Museum, it dates from 890 to 710 BC. Accidentally discovered in 1986 near the mouth of Lumbong River, the Laguna Copper Plate inscription is the earliest historical document in the country and also the only pre-Spanish document discovered so far. Now a national cultural treasure, the LCI measures 7 by 12 inches when unrolled. In 1990, the National Museum purchased the LCI and sought help from Antoon Postma, a Dutch national who was then the director of the Mang Yan Assistance and Research Center, to decipher the inscription. Postma, with the help of Dr. Johan de Casparis, later found out that the LCI was written in Kavi, an old Javanese writing system, and the language used was a combination of Old Tagalog, Old Javanese, Old Malay, and Sanskrit. Even more surprising is the fact that the Philippines' oldest document was neither a poem nor a song but a legal document called sutapatra, which, in today's context, is a receipt for payment of debt. The Gold Death Mask of Aten, another national cultural treasure, was discovered in the 1960s by Alfredo Evangelista and F. Landa Jokan. It consists of a gold nose disc and eye mask, both of which were found in a grave site in San Antonio, Aten, Iloilo. The gold mask, dated from the late 14th to the early 15th century AD, is the first of its kind recovered in the Philippines. It was part of an ancient burial practice, with the gold mask serving as an amulet against evil spirits. The practice of using a gold mask to cover the face of the dead was brought to the Philippines by the southern Chinese. Around that time, Aten was a center of the trade route, so it didn't take long before a limited group of Filipinos started to adopt the custom. The formidable Bolinao skull is only one of 67 skulls recovered from the Baling Gasai archaeological site in Bolinao, Pangasinan. They were found along with several early Ming Dynasty 1368-1644. The dental ornamentation consists of pegging with gold plates in a fish scale design or pattern and pegged with gold wire rivets. The gold decorations on the teeth are like tiny nails with flat rounded tops of heads and placed in a bored hole on the teeth, overlapping one another, like fish scales. Teeth that are decorated with gold ornaments is a symbol of wealth and bravery during the prehistoric era. This golden figurine of a female deity is the first image identified to be of Indian origin. In 1917, it was accidentally discovered by a Manobo woman in the banks of the Wawa River in Agusan, Mindanao, after a heavy rain. Shortly after that, Philippines pioneer prehistorian H. Otley Vayer declared it as the most spectacular find yet made in Philippine archaeology. Which measures 5.5 inches tall and weighs nearly 4 pounds of 21 karat gold. As for its origin, Bayer suggested that it was made by a Javanese expatriate who was mining Agusan for gold at that time. Dutch historian F. D. K. Bosch, on the other hand, said that it was made by a pre-colonial Filipino because the design lacks the distinct Javanese craftsmanship. If the second theory is to be believed, the gold image of Agusan suggests that the prehistoric Filipinos were influenced by the traders from the Hindu-Malayan culture, such as the Majapahit Empire. The Visayas, for instance, is said to be named after the last Southeast Hindu prince Srivijaya. From 2011 to 2012, National Museum archaeologists unearthed a total of 15 limestone tombs and other valuable artifacts in Mount Camhantic near Mulanay Town in Quezon Province. The archaeological site, which is part of a 280-hectare government-protected land, is believed to be the area where a 1,000-year-old village once stood. Unlike other archaeological sites previously explored in the country, this burial ground features limestone coffins, a first in the Philippines and a proof that our ancestors also used a more advanced burial ritual. Based on the carbon dating tests done on the human tooth found in one of the graves, the village existed approximately during 10th to 14th century. In 2007, a group of archaeologists led by Dr. Armand Villares of UP Diliman discovered a foot bone in Calo Cave in the town of Peñablanca, Cagayan. The said skeletal remains, specifically the third metatarsal of the foot, is said to be the earliest human fossil found in the Asia-Pacific region. Based on a method called uranium series dating, it was also revealed that the foot bone is approximately 67,000 years old, predating the Taban man, long been thought to be the country's earliest human remains, which is only 50,000 years old. The Calo man, according to experts, possibly reached the island of Luzon from Indonesia by raft, which suggests that our ancestors already possessed knowledge of seacraft making in this early period. However, other experts believe that the Calo man is probably just a species closely related to humans and was a product of an evolutionary process called human speciation.